All right, Extreme Performance Systems 15 or XPS 15. Let's go over the raw stats. For pricing, XPS 15 starts at $1,250. With that, you get a laptop that's advertised as the world's smallest 15.6-inch performance class laptop. It's 15 inches. Its display is Full HD+, meaning a little better than 1080p. For connectivity, it's pretty much got everything you need, but the built-in camera could be a little better. For internal specs, it's okay. An Intel Core i5-11400H with integrated graphics. So for the price, perhaps it could be a little better. It starts with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage, so I would recommend an external drive unless you can manage. And lastly, it's Windows 11 compatible. The top three reviewer acclaims that I found were great display, good battery, and thin bezels. The top three complaints I found were poor webcam, CPU throttling under heavy load, and price. So just like with the XPS 17, the XPS 15 is well-rounded. These laptops are built to do anything. They just can't excel in everything. A jack of all trades is a master of none, but better than a master of one. So if you want a laptop that you can use for primarily school and work, but also you can play games and watch movies with, this laptop is a great option. But what differentiates it from its bigger brother? Is this laptop a better option? Well, that's kind of your opinion, but we can narrow it down. Firstly, let's talk about size. Do you have the ability to carry a 17-inch laptop with you wherever you go? Remember, that's 2 inches in diameter, so it's actually a fairly significant amount for some people. And the weight could also be a factor. The XPS 17 obviously weighs more than the XPS 15. But ultimately, I believe the biggest factor is money. The starter XPS 15 is $500 cheaper than the XPS 17. Now, it doesn't have as good of a processor, as much RAM, or as great of a display as its bigger brother, but that might be negligible given the price. Do you need a faster processor and RAM right now? Or perhaps down the line? Think really hard about what you need right now, but also in the future. Because in retrospect, $500 is a lot of money, but it's not nearly as much as you would have to pay if you buy an entirely new laptop a few years down the line because the original one you purchased could not handle the workload. So really think hard about this decision and ask yourself what you're going to be doing with this laptop. Because ultimately, this is a big investment and you definitely want to get the most out of your money. Ultimately though, all of this is your decision based on your preferences. Don't just watch one single video about this device. I've linked many more down in the description to watch at your discretion. Thank you very much for watching, good luck with your purchase, and have a wonderful day.